Ernest Mayer. Ernest Mayer, he described as 20th century of Darwin. 20th century of Darwin is Ernest Mayer. He explained that origin of species diversity. In living organism, origin of species diversity in that living organism. So it is important point about that objective also. Who has that 20th century of Darwin? Ernest Mayer. He explained that for the first time origin of species of diversity after Charles Darwin scientist. Charles Darwin scientist explained that evolution theory. So in his book Origin of Species. After that, origin of species, okay, Ernest Mayer, so explained that for the first time, origin of species diversity, that's why he described as 20th century of Darwin, okay. After that, chapter is that the living world. It is an introduction. For scientific contribution, for scientist contribution after the living world. So in that living world chapter, so first, what is meaning of living? What is life? What are the living organisms? Okay, so which organism having that okay, certain features or characters, so they are known as considered as a living organism. So what are them? Growth, reproduction, ability to sense environment, ability to sense environment and provide and show suitable response. Ability to sense environment shows suitable response. That means irritability. It is also known as irritability. Self-replicate, self-organize, emergence, and after that interaction. So, growth, reproduction, ability to sense environment shows suitable response, that is known as that irritability, self-replicate, self-organize, emergence, interaction. So these are that living characters, that is known as the life. Okay, so in this, what is that first you take that growth, what is the meaning of the growth? Continue. So after that, growth, it is the first one, it is that growth. All living organisms are grow. All living organisms are grow. All living organisms are grow. Okay. So it means, for example, this all living organisms are grow. So it means, for example, a multicellular organism, growth takes place by cell division. Growth occurs by సెల్ డివిజన్, రైట్? ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్, సో ఇట్ ఈస్ దట్ ఆల్ లివింగ్ ఆర్గానిజమ్స్ ఆర్ గ్రో, ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ మల్టీ సెల్యులర్ ఆర్గానిజం గ్రోత్ అక్కర్స్ బై సెల్ డివిజన్. ప్లాంట్స్ కెన్ గ్రో, ఓకే, ప్లాంట్స్ కెన్ గ్రో, ఇట్ మీన్స్ త్రూ అవుట్ దట్ లైఫ్ పీరియడ్, throughout life span or life period, because due to the presence of meristems. Why plants can grow throughout the life period? Okay, because due to the presence of meristem. So it is objective bit. So meristem means it is a group of it is a tissue. In the cells are always divide and redivide producing of the new cells. Cells divide, produce new cells. So that is known as that meristem. Due to the presence of meristem, plants can grow throughout that lifespan. Okay. So after that, animals. Animals can grow only certain period of growth, right? But animals can grow at a certain stage, only at a certain stage. After that, growth is stopped. Okay, it is mainly involved by that, depend upon that hormones. The growth is depend upon that hormones in animals, okay, because absent of the meristem, so in animals growth is stopped, right? So after that, in some tissues, so growth is, it means growth is, cell division is takes place, but that replace the loss of cells. Loss of cells in some organism, okay? So replace the loss of cells, growth occurs, replace the loss of cells in some tissue by cell division. Right? So that is the process of that, it means characters of that, some important character of the growth. So after that, so growth can be measured, okay? Growth can be measured, yes or no? Yes, growth can be measured. Growth can be measured, okay, by the counting of number of cells. By the counting of number of cells in vitro, it means in artificial medium, okay, at cell division with the help by microscope. By microscope, it means growth can be measured by the counting of number of cells in vitro, means in artificial nutrient medium outside of the body at cell division, during the time of cell division, by microscope. Okay, unicellular organisms also grow. It is objective bit. Unicellular organisms. Unicellular organisms can grow. Okay, until up to divide, right? So it means unicellular organisms also can grow until up to divide. So it means before dividing, so cell is grows, okay, certain, okay, amount. So after then growth is completed, then divided is start. It means, what is the meaning? Unicellular organisms can grow until up to divide. So before dividing, cell grows at a certain size, okay? So it means that is known as it. Next, non-living objects also grow. Non-living objects can grow. So what are that example? For example, you take that mountains. boulders and sand mounds. Mountains, boulders, okay, and sand mounds can grow. How it is that? By the accumulation of material on surface. By the accumulation means formation. By the accumulation of material on surface. So it means in non-living objects can grow by externally. By external. So it is objective bit. Right? So how it is that? Example, mountains, boulders, sand mounds, by the accumulation of material on the surface, so their non-living object can grow external. And living organism can grow internal. Living organisms grow internally or internal, right? Okay, so it is a living objects, it is known that non-living objects. Dead organism does not grow. That's why growth is not a perfect living character, because living objects, it means living organisms and non-living objects, both can grow. That's why growth is not the defining property of a living organism. So that is that growth. Okay, so growth is completed.